might bribe Jim Shanahan with M&Ms so they could switch bunks and we could whisper in the night. I think about when we were teenagers and our parents rented vacation homes in Hyannis and we'd go down to the beach and just swim up and down the shore for hours just talking. I think about our first summer back from college when Mike and I reunited at the Kennedy Breakwater and Mike first told me he was gay. The sun is fighting back the January clouds as it goes behind the park. I run from 53rd and 50th East Drive, past the zoo, the dairy, a payphone, a jam in a quarter, and dial Mike. Nothing. Try again. I get his machine. God damn it, I slam down the phone and keep running. I'm running past the zoo, the dairy, up through the woods. The sheep's meadow's empty. I spin myself around in circles and stagger around like a wild. The tick boom is so loud. I can't hear the rain on the grass. I can't hear the wind. I'm about to scream when I realize I'm not a- I'm not alone. Across from me on the hill are hundreds of seagulls. I run at them like a castaway singing in a rescue plane. I fly en masse, only to land on another hill across the way. I talk to them. My friend is dying! I'm lost. I'm afraid. I'm running past the statue of Shakespeare, up through the woods to the top of Belvedere Castle. I look down at the empty Delacorte Theater. Behind some trees, I see an old rehearsal piano. I climb down through the woods, hop another fence, and remove the tarp.
My time.
time this way. With only so much time to spend, don't want to waste the time I'm given. Have it all, play the game, some recommend. I'm afraid it may just be time to give in. I'm 29. Michael and I live on the west side of Soho and Y. 9 a.m. I write a lyric or two. Mike sings his song out on Mad Avenue. I sing, come to your senses, defenses are not the way to go. Right here.